In this video, we're gonna show you what the upgrade of the Tesla's computer looks like. We're gonna upgrade the main brain of the Tesla, the MCU, or the media control unit, and the full self-driving computer. Let's take a look. So on the surface, nothing really looks different. The computer and the overall car, the display, everything looks the same. Really, the differences are under the hood. The media center computer is the main computer that drives the entertainment system. So the music, the maps, the entertainment system, and the full self-driving computer controls how the car actually drives when it's self-driving using the cameras that are all around the car. Combined, the upgrade gives the car new capabilities, both in terms of features in games and entertainment, as well as an improved experience in self-driving. So let's take a look at some of those. So this is a 2017 Tesla model. In between the years of 2012 and 2018, Tesla used the NVIDIA Tegra chipset in its MCU computer. After 2018, early 2018, Tesla switched to the new Intel computer, and that really accelerated the graphics, made gaming faster, and made the overall experience significantly smoother. Now, the MCU upgrade is around $2,500. The full self-driving upgrade is around $6,000 with software and hardware. Now, if you're spending close to $7,000-$8,000 on an upgrade and you're doing that just for gaming, it's probably not a good value. It's really expensive to upgrade just for the gaming. And obviously upgrading the car for $7,000 is much less expensive than upgrading the entire car, which could cost significantly more. So the process of ordering is pretty straightforward. You make the order through the mobile application, you confirm the order through the mobile application, and you set up your appointment. From there, I simply drove to my local Tesla store, dropped off the car, they had everything ready to go, and they even gave me a loaner of older generation Tesla that I could try out for the day. The following day I came back and the car was ready. And the first thing I really experienced when I tried out the new MCU was it was significantly faster, everything was a lot smoother, it's really easy to use, everything was fluid. But the thing that really surprised me was that the entire experience was brand new. So all of my settings, all my favorites, all my connections to my phone, Bluetooth, they were all wiped away. And so really I needed to start from scratch and set up the car as a brand new car. So all of the configuration, all of the radio stations, all of those normal settings that I'd set up to be just the way I liked them, I had to kind of go back into the settings and reconfigure the car. Now, when I was getting the upgrade, one of the drawbacks that I knew from the outset was that the upgraded MCU didn't have AM/FM radio. And so the reason it didn't have AM/FM radio was that the original MCU1 was an analog tuner and the upgraded MCU was a digital tuner. And so this is just one of the drawbacks of having the upgraded MCU, is that there was no digital tuner in the car. Now, you're able to mitigate this by really dialing in all of those digital stations via streaming. So the TuneIn application has all my favorite stations, so I was able to do that. Now let's get to the fun part, which is the driving. The driving experience of the new MCU, the full self-driving computer, is really smooth. You get a lot of new updates, a lot of new visuals on the on-screen display, so traffic lights, cones, stop signs, things of that nature. And really, over the next months and years, this is really what Tesla is going to be upgrading. They're going to be improving that driving experience, improving that self-driving, and that's really what I'm looking forward to. That was the primary reason for me to get the upgrade. Now, all of the major features that are based on full self-driving, including summon and some of the features for parking, parallel parking, and otherwise, they all seem really smooth. And again, I expect those features to continue to improve month over month, year over year. So really looking forward to some of those improvements over time as well. A lot of new features that were just fun to play around with, like karaoke, allows you to sing karaoke in the car.
Yay, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
And of course, the web browser. Here's what the old web browser experience looks like. And so I'm just pulling up my web page, and it just sits there on the white screen, never really loads. And here's what it looks like with the new MCU. I hit the web page, and a couple seconds later, it loads right back up. So huge marked difference in terms of performance. The other thing to note is with this upgraded MCU and the upgraded browsing experience, you can have services like Netflix and YouTube, and this is all inside the Tesla Theater. So again, great for the kids, or if you're supercharging, you have a couple of minutes to spare. Now, let's talk about games. The updated games are great. You obviously have a number of games that Tesla has released, including Beach Buggy Racing, Starview Valley, and a number of other ones. And I'm expecting additional games to be coming out as well. Now, is Tesla a software company or a hardware company? And that's really the question. That's the thing that makes this upgrade exciting, is because Tesla is really a hybrid, and there's not a lot of companies that are both software companies and hardware companies producing some of the world's best software and some of the most exciting innovations in the software space, but also able to keep up with the pace of hardware. So really excited about this. Again, don't forget to take your garage door clicker with you. Otherwise, you won't be able to get into your garage, which was my problem when I was getting the upgrade. So thanks again for sticking with me. Appreciate your time. Have a good one. Thanks.